Hey guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel, Beauty Intakes. If you're new, hi, I'm Divya. So today's makeup look is about just using 3products to create makeup look, and this is what I have come up with. I have made so many of my products to multitask. Even the aloe vera gel has performed a lot of job in today's video. So how we created this makeup look, or just for fun, if you're interested to watch, then please keep on watching. And then okay, I have not used any tools, so if you are in a hurry and if you have nothing, then something is better than nothing. So for those situations, this makeup look can help you out. And now let's get started. So firstly, I have used aloe vera gel as my moisturizer plus primer. This is a very affordable option. Not only it hydrates your skin in this winter season, which is quite dry, but also it adds a slightly tacky texture to your skin. This makes your foundation easily stickable to your skin and make it last long. Also, as per my personal experience, I also feel like aloe vera gel makes your skin much more smooth as compared to any cream based moisturizer. So that's why I have used aloe vera gel. Now next, I have taken my moisturizer, which is by Patanjali, and I have taken my foundation, Maybelline Fit Me. You can use any foundation that you have. I have taken a pea-sized amount of moisturizer and mixed with my foundation. Now what this does is it actually makes your foundation more hydrating and takes away the complete mattifying effect, which is not desirable in the winter season. Plus it adds a slight bit of glow to your skin, so your foundation does not look a complete mask like. And also the third thing is adding some moisturizer make your foundation easily blendable with your fingers. If you do not have brush, then do mix your moisturizer with your foundation. So here I have dotted all over my face, and also cover your eyelids with this, just so that all of the dark circles and the darkness of the eyelid is concealed. And always use slightly dab motion before you make the sliding motion, the swiping motions. That would be a more easier way if you want your foundation to blend. And take your time to blend. With fingers, it does take a lot of time to blend, so be patient and take your own time and blend it until you are happy with the finish. Next up, I have taken my foundation, and this only I'll be using as my concealer. Now if you do not have very prominent dark circles, this works amazingly. A second layer of foundation do work as a concealer as well. All you need to do is use a second layer of it, dot it over your eyelids and below your eyelids, below your eyes, and blend it. Take your time to blend with fingers. It does take a lot of time to blend. So please take your own time and make your foundation blend into your eyelids completely. Now don't worry if you do not have a compact powder. Your talcum powder that you have been using since your childhood works really fine as setting powder as well. So all you need to take is this 10 rupees Pond's bottle. Take it out in your hand and set your T-zone with this, applying majorly over the nose wherever you tend to get oily. Now in my case, I get oily very close to the nose, and set your eyelid just so that your eyeshadow, which we'll be using in the next process, does not creases. And then whatever is left on your hand, just distribute all over your hand and then press it all over your face, just so that your foundation does last long. But if you have dry skin, then you can totally skip this process. For the next step, we'll make our cheeks flush pink. So all you need to do is take your favorite lipstick. It should be in a pink shade, and even better if you use a liquid lipstick, because they blend very easily on your skin. So I have used a bullet lipstick because I believe this is something that most of the people own. So use your lipstick as your blush and blend it very nicely. And for the daytime look, you can just add a hint of color on your eyelids as well. So all I have done is taken this all over my fingers and used on my eyelids. Now intensity of the color on your eyelids is completely your choice. If you want dark color, then you can use dark colors, and intense color, then you can intensify the look. But all I like is a hint of color in the daytime, and so I have done very light application of my lipstick over my eyelids. Kajal are such a staple in Indian bridal or makeup kits that it would be really injustice to the makeup if we don't use kajal. So I have used my kajal not only to line my under waterline, but also I have used to tight line my eyes. That is, I have also used on my upper waterline as well as on a lower waterline. You can absolutely use it as your eyeliner as well, but I do not like a black liner in the daytime, so I have skipped this process as of now. And then all what I have done is for my mascara, to give it a wet effect, I have used my aloe vera gel as my mascara. With this, my eyelashes look wet, but if in case you have ended up making them clumpy, then all you can do is take a lash comb and comb your lashes with it. Or else what you can do is take that fine tooth comb, which is used to take out lice. You can use that comb to comb out your lashes, and that combing will give that uplifting effect and curling effect to your lashes as well. So make sure that you do that necessarily. Now for the night look, you can just take your kohl pencil and use it to make your eyes look smoky. All you need to do is just apply your kajal in any random way. I have used it very close to my lash line, and just use it all over your lids and then smudge it with your fingers. Now again, intensity of the smokiness and the darkness of the kajal on your eyelids is a personal choice. Personally, I do not like very intense black smoky eyes, so I have used slight hint of color, and then after I have intensified it slightly, you can just make it as intense as you want or as light as you want. Now I promise that making a smoky effect on your eyelids give them a slight bit of definition and makes your eye look attractive without making it too over dramatic, but then again just adding a slight bit of definition and feel like you have just done something and some efforts, but the thing is you haven't added that much of effort over your eye look. So do this slightly and then smudge it. And so I completed up the look with a little bit of nude lipstick, but you can again pair it with any lipstick that you like, because it is a soft smoky eye. Reds and brown even will go. And lastly, I have used my lip balm as my highlighter. Do not use lip balm over your cheeks or it will mess up with your foundation and compact, but you can use it over small portions of your face like bridge of your nose, tip of your nose, on your cupid bow and on your chin. And that is the only portion I've used my lip balm as my highlighter, just so that my face has slight bit of shine. And that's it. This is the final finished look. I hope that you find this one helpful, and my posing session, as always, quite weird. And if you did, then do not forget to like the video, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and if you have already subscribed, then thank you so much for your favor to this channel. I'll see you in my next one. Up to then, bye bye and take care.